Thank you to Astapro for sponsoring this video. It's a nasal allergy spray that I've been a loyal customer to for quite some time now. Tell you more about them in just a little bit, Reject Nation. Citizens of the Reject Nation, we are back. The animated dynamic duo is back to watch some animation. See what I did there? We read your comments and you were like, when are they going back to DC Animation? Why aren't they doing those anymore? Well, we're going a little different. We're pivoting to Spectacular Spider-Man because, against all odds, this is, I think, the only adaptation of my favorite character in the history of comic books, Spider-Man, that I haven't seen. So I'm about to find out what this Spectacular Spider-Man has been up to. Are you excited?
I am so excited. I know nothing about this other than apparently it has a banger theme tune.
Ooh, I know Josh Keaton is in it because he's friends with my buddy Yuri, and Yuri and him are both Spider-Man, but I've never heard his Spider-Man.
You gotta get them together to do the thing.
Oh, at the premiere, we did many a point. I haven't gotten to know why people were excited. People are like, oh my gosh, Josh Keaton, I'm about to experience it. So this came out 2008. I have not seen a single episode. Fun fact, I'll tell you after the episodes. Hold on to that thought. We're going to watch the first two episodes and then review them both. So don't be alarmed if we don't pause after the first. We're diving all the way in. And as always, please do like, please subscribe, please hit that notification bell, please hit that comment bar. Let us know which is your favorite episode without spoilers so we know what to look forward to. Do the things. And remember, if you want to head over to Patreon, you can watch our full reaction of both episodes unbroken with our resting watching faces. And also over at Patreon, John and Greg do exclusive watch-alongs over there where you can sync up with your own copy, and it's like hanging out on the couch watching stuff with them and us over there. Also, much love to the fine folks at Prepper who make this possible, the unsung heroes of the YouTube game. Much love, Prepper. All right, without further ado, let's get into Spider-Man. There he is.
That's Peter.
That's Peter. Peter Spider Parker.
Oh. Oh.
Tell me there's something better.
Like them gargoyles.
Go ahead. Try.
He is a fun voice, Peter.
Peter Benjamin Parker. I can sum it up in one glorious hyphenated word. Spider-Man.
Yeah.
I am the Spectacular Spider-Man.
He said the thing.
Right at the top.
It's my last night before school starts, and I can really use some action.
I like the bokeh. I like the blurry city with him foreground.
Yeah.
Give some depth.
Ooh.
Jazzy Spider-Man.
Uh-oh. Trouble at the jewelry center.
Oh, nothing good goes there with Sandman.
One getaway jump to the next building and we're $1 million richer.
This ain't no $1 million haul. Not after the big man takes his cut anyway.
Shut up and jump.
The big man.
Kingpin?
Kingpin, yeah.
Oh, no, not again.
Yep, again.
Ah!
Just wait till I get my hands on you, you skinny little creep.
Does he always have a spider spotlight?
Oh, yeah, they just never use it. It's in his belt.
What?
And it's literally that.
I'm just not sure it screams friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
He's even commenting on it, doesn't he?
This is a live feed, then I've seen enough.
Oh.
Is that Keith
that's
David?
That's some Keith David action.
Summon the enforcers.
Already on their way.
Oh, let's go.
Always Keith David.
Oh. Okay, ooh. What's this going to be?
Amazing Fantasy 15 cover. Ooh. Nicely done. Oh.
The Origins.
It's like early 2000s alt rock.
Yeah.
Little dad rocky, a little, yeah. Oh. Ooh, I like these character designs.
Yeah.
Ooh, these pants are back in style. We're back. Black costumes coming at some point.
Spider-Man! Spectacular! That part kind of sounded like The Offspring a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Good call. He's actually enjoying New York. Stay in New York, young man.
Yeah.
All right. All right. So far, it's a bop.
Well done. Lived up to the hype.
Ooh, survival of the fittest.
I've never been so pumped for the first day of school because today, everything changes.
Does it now?
It isn't getting any easier, Anna. We're almost out of money.
But May, I'm sure Ben left
Ben
him.
Parker was many, many wonderful things.
But not an entrepreneur.
We'll manage. And please, not a word of this to Peter.
Oh.
I wouldn't want him to be concerned.
In an alternate timeline, he's rich.
You don't want to be late on your first day.
No, ma'am.
In an alternate timeline, Ben is a financial wizard who, like, shoots money.
And he buys his spider powers.
That's right.
Because he can.
You told me to bring my magnetic air transport system to Oscorp.
Ooh, is that a vulture? Or is it just Mendelsohn?
She studied my ideas and rejected them.
Gotta be vulture. It's tech flight.
I am sorry, Adrian.
Don't you dare apologize.
Adrian Toomes.
Oscorp has nothing to apologize for.
Great character design.
You stole my work!
That's dangerous talk, Mr. Toomes. Dangerous and unsupportable.
Uh-oh.
You've been at this for decades without one success to your name. If you never accomplished anything as a young man, who'd believe you created Tech Flight as an old one?
Wow.
Ouch. What about the wisdom Business. Gained over time?
Good news. I don't blame you anymore.
You're safe, buddy.
Vulture v. Green Goblin's coming.
Wow. Love how I did the bad guy nail look.
Yep, that's how you check.
Hey, Pete.
Harry, Gwen.
Oh.
Oh, Gwen looks like Liz.
My dad spent the whole trip locked in boardroom, so I spent mine locked in boredom.
Ah, bars.
I should have stayed in town with you, Pete. At least we could have done nothing together.
Harry looks just like
his
pops.
Oh, he did the face thing. You know he's Spider-Man.
You ready for the torture that is M cubed?
It'll be different now.
Oh.
Oh, Mary Jane, I'm assuming.
Oh.
Oh, no. Who is this young lady?
Hello there.
Liz Allen? Betty Brandt? Who's it gonna be? Betty's usually got brown hair. We'll see.
It's Barbie!
It's Margot Robbie.
It's just Margot Robbie in an animated cameo.
Pete?
Whoa.
Where are you going?
I like his confidence.
Face my destiny.
Going off spider sense.
Destiny.
Sally?
Sally?
Are you damaged?
Whoa.
Why in the world do you think I'd ever go out with Midtown High's champion geek?
Ooh.
Ouch.
Puny Parker's hitting on your girl.
I didn't know you two were...
School.
Cool?
School.
You don't care?
You want to go out with him?
I want to walk on a Parker-free planet. Thank you very much.
Wow.
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 If your geek sweat got within 1 mile of Liz,
back off, Flash. I won't be your punching bag anymore.
Oh, so he's newly Spidey.
Ooh. Damn, Flash is like all-American.
Oh, he usually, yeah.
Nerd thinks he's Spider-Man.
You got another thing coming, buddy.
And canonically, Flash is like the biggest Spidey fan, so it's it's great.
I was gonna say, I'm used to Manganiello, Tony Revolori, one guy from Amazing Spider-Man who's
Zylka.
Like skinny.
Yeah. Chris Zylka, I think his name was.
Enforcers all present and accounted for, boss.
Oh, the enforcers!
For the last 4 months, a pest has plagued our operations. At first, I could hardly credit the reports.
Thought the boys were trying to stiff us.
Stop, boys.
Establishing patterns of movement took all summer, but last night...
Oh, Fancy Dan?
Yeah.
The Spider-Man is real.
And you want the enforcers to wrangle up this here spider?
No, Montana.
I want pictures of him.
Oh, that's Montana, okay.
I want you to squash it.
Squash the spider.
Mr. Parker, Ms. Stacy, I wonder if either of you remember a field trip we took last year to the laboratory of Dr. Curtis Connors?
Oh.
Uh-oh.
It's where it all changed.
Do I
So it was
remember.
A year ago. Interesting. So it's a year one story.
Okay. You gotta sprinkle those origins across the story.
Yes, we've seen him a couple times.
They know.
He's offering 2 internships to promising high schoolers.
Aw.
Okay.
I recommended my 2-star pupils. You start this afternoon.
Dang.
No decision. You're going.
I love the little spider
Your transitions. Yeah.
Man Spider makes those.
Obviously. The rich one.
Yeah.
Oh, Vulture.
Thanks for letting me kill time at your place, Harry.
I'm just surprised you're not hanging at the school paper. Aren't you their star photographer or something?
Someone else can take pictures of Flash prancing around the gridiron.
Oh, God.
This part of the same reality where Sally Avril's your...
A minor setback. At least this lab job solves the Parker money problems.
I'm glad they didn't burn a character we know. That random girl named Sally Avril.
I couldn't help overhearing.
I'm sorry, Mr. Osborn.
Don't you dare apologize, son. So what's this about a lab job?
At ESU, working with Curt Connors.
Connors, huh? Quite an opportunity.
Simpson, eh?
Very much that energy.
It's totally not a big deal, Mr. O, but thanks. We'll get out of your way now.
Mr. O, Mysterio?
Oh, it's it!
Oh, shit!
Oh, he's gonna do it right here! Gotta stay inside.
Whoa!
Spider-Man, do something!
Whoa!
Can't do it in front of Harry, but go!
He just got straight kidnapped!
Call the cops! Do it! Go!
Call the police!
Smart.
Gonna have to come back for those.
Tell the truth, Osborn. Can your tech fight do this?
Whoa!
That was awesome. Animation's great.
Yeah.
I'm what you call me. I'm the Vulture.
I called you a buzzard.
I was going to say, yeah.
The buzzard. Oh, that's great.
Same diff.
Toomes, stop. What will any of this accomplish?
A means to an end, Osborn. Something you know all about.
Oh, boy.
You will pay me all that I am owed, and you will publicly apologize for stealing my invention.
Sure.
I love that they set that up.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Come on, Spider-Man, now's the time.
Yeah.
There it is.
Yeah.
You play hot potato hardcore.
Hardcore potato.
You are the bossiest damsel in distress.
I like him tossing him. I've actually never seen that. He's going between iconic holds.
Who are
oh, that's
you?
Cool.
Why, I'm your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, of course.
There
yes,
it is,
you
another
are.
Drop.
I thought you were a myth. Hey, I need a new press agent.
Myth busted.
Oh, oh no!
Get him!
He's not helping Stan. The perps he nabs almost always walk.
You were saying.
Not helping.
Oh no! You should add a bowling pin sound effect there.
What's going on?
Explanations inside!
Yeah.
Yup.
Beaky, I admire anyone who dresses up as their favorite animal. You heard the one about great power coming with great responsibility?
Oh, backwards swinging.
Whoa, Beaky, don't fly away, mad.
The name is Vulture!
Dope, dope.
I don't think that's the last we've seen of him.
Ah, he's done. He's
that's
fine.
It, he's retired.
He's a good guy now.
I tried to follow him on foot, and I ran for blocks, but...
Is he in the socks?
Yeah.
Hey, look, I'm late, and Gwen's giving me the look, so bye.
I so was not giving you the look.
Aww.
But I am late, right?
Always, bro.
But I am late.
Half right.
I'm the Connors' personal lab assistant. Not bad for a frosh, huh?
Hey.
Eddie Brock's a freshman.
College freshman.
Oh.
Whoa.
I'm guessing you're missing me at Midtown High, huh? Want to keep Court. Flash Thompson off your back?
They're going the ultimate Spider-Man route.
Jews again,
oh,
huh?
That's true. They did keep the continuity.
Nice.
All right, I respect it.
And he's already got his Venom colors.
Yep.
I'd like you to meet Dr. Martha Connors.
Eddie's told us great things about you both.
Said you wore clean underwear. Lucky I didn't say socks.
Interesting to have Eddie Brock already, like, appear.
Yeah.
Definitely ultimate vibes.
I'll be right out.
What are you doing there,
Gwen,
bud?
This is ESU's resident genius, my husband, Kurt.
It's an honor to meet you, Dr. Connors.
Weird handshake.
Didn't offer the left, the back of his hand.
What does this gig pay?
You're a high school kid with zero experience.
Yeah.
You're not getting paid.
You get paid experience.
Yep, that's how it starts.
The lizard, this is a lizard!
Oh, he's got a lizard!
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Pete, don't angst, okay? It'll come to you.
Don't angst.
Don't angst. I do love that little tag always sticking out.
Yeah, it's great. It's very Peter Parker.
I'm waiting!
Oh, let's go.
You gotta admit, the girl knows her stuff.
Go take pictures of Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Oh, I like the spider fade from the back logo.
Yeah, definitely.
And they're using the flat iron, which Sam Raimi used as the bugle.
Mm-hmm.
Robbie, where's my layout? Boswell, I ordered that rewrite 12 seconds ago. And you!
Me?
Yeah, you! I sent you for my bagel and schmear 9 minutes ago.
Oh, no!
Actually, sir, I've got something better than a bagel.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Whoa.
Great, Jonah.
I think I can get you pictures of Spider-Man in action.
What do you know about selling papers?
No!
You're a kid! Worse, you're a teenager! Call security! Get this wailing infant out of my face!
Oh, my God!
Out of my town!
Out of my town!
I would love if he followed through with
what
that.
What the bugle needs is photos of Spider-Man.
So Jonah, exactly
it.
Correct.
I love it.
Oh, that's so good.
The amazing Spider-Man is reduced to sneaking around for his shoes.
Oh, it's okay, buddy. I hope he works that out over the course of the season.
A whole season. Gets
more
his shoes
convenient
back.
Shoes. Oh.
Go, go.
Nope.
Use the garage. Go underground.
Target sighted at last.
Whoa.
Cool.
Whoa.
Let's squash us above.
This is freaking mustache. The enforcers are great with masks on. I've never seen that.
I mean, you are celebrating Halloween in September, right?
I am always.
All year.
I like the subtle, like, perspective parallaxes and stuff that
yeah,
they're able to work in.
And the Boku is so great all the time here. It's great.
No idea what that big bird's about, but I am mighty glad he's keeping our bug busy. Target locked.
The alliteration on this dude.
Oh, yeah. Some of the writing on those old guys was fantastic.
Dang. You've been outwebbed.
No.
Gargoyles crossover. Gargoyles crossover.
That's about to. No, not in the way you'd want.
Yes. How did Spidey die?
Gargoyle crossover.
Oh, in the nuts. Right in the Parkers. Oh, no, the mustache.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
That hurt all of us.
Dang.
Who is this?
Y'all are agile. Oh, yeah. Spidey sense. He's doing the Charlie Chaplin. Oh, this is great.
Boys need a workout. Now, no turning tail.
Seriously, who are you guys?
Who are you people?
I don't remember the enforcers keeping up acrobatically. It's impressive.
Dang. Well, this guy's got, like, the high frame rate motions.
Yeah.
Woo. Yeah. Aw.
There's this vulture guy out there, so if we could just postpone...
Oh. Oh, my God.
Can you do this?
Woo.
Didn't think so.
Nice.
Now, I know you can tear right through that. I wouldn't recommend it.
Great. Oh, can opener.
Oh, boy.
Man, this is a sweet ride.
Hey. It's got, like, turf.
Yeah, why was it, like, green?
Like turf in the back seat.
Ah, lasers.
Never fought anyone like this group of bozos.
Voltran versus in one.
They're much more than bozos.
Can't let Harry lose his dad the way I lost Uncle Ben.
The vulture killed Uncle Ben?
We don't know the origin.
In a limousine?
Very specific scenario to repeat itself. My one weakness, garages. I said earlier that's what he should have done. Now here we are.
You know, you should write for these guys.
I know the Spider-Man guy.
Two birds, one stone.
There it is, yeah, with the pun.
Yeah.
Where'd that varmint get to now?
Varmint.
Yeah.
Did you really think you could hide from me?
Cool. Clever. Nope. That's not what I'm trying to do.
Clipped his wings. Two birds, one stone.
I can't steer. Yeah, but you're still airborne. How does that work exactly? Yo, Vulture, you're humming.
Oh!
You doomed us both.
You so have not been paying attention.
Yeah, dude.
Well, 3 out of 4 ain't bad. Especially on bizarre bad guy night. If I can just get my shoes.
I love the undercurrent of the B plot with the shoes. It's great.
Oh, perfect end to a perfect day.
Aunt May and Gwen Stacy wear their hair the exact same way.
Ah, that's a good point. And specific.
I can't have you out till midnight. You're to be home by 10 o'clock. That's the law in this house, Peter. Do we understand each other?
Yes, ma'am.
That's fair.
How about a slice of banana cream pie?
Yeah.
I'm still Spider-Man and still undefeated. And I still have this amazing person watching out for me. Tell me there's something better. Go ahead, try.
I can't, what? Peter.
You gotta see what you got in life. Gratitude and appreciation. Oh,
how lovely, watching over the neighborhood.
That's such a comic shot. That's beautiful. I love
that. Oh, well done.
Good D. Pilot, Bradley good Baker. Pilot.
Oh, I want to catch all the names. Robert Englund was the vulture. Dang.
Wow, that's exciting.
Yeah, all right, all
also
right.
Didn't realize that was meant to be Jean DeWolf. That's exciting. Jean DeWolf's a very important character that hasn't been adapted yet.
Okay.
She's a cop that has a high importance later.
Okay, I like important cops in comic books.
We'll see if they go
books.
There.
Well, maybe they'll go there in episode 2.
Perhaps episode 2 will feature more Jean DeWolf.
Spider-Man. In fact, speaking of episode 2,
we're
Coy,
going right into episode 2.
Why don't we just go into episode 2?
I think
two.
We should flesh play in 3, 2, episode 2.
In nature, everything is connected. As scientists, we explore and expand upon those connections to the benefit of society.
Okay.
We're experimenting with genetically altered electric rays in eels.
Good.
I sense an Electro.
Think what it would mean if we could harness this bioelectricity, generate an alternate form of energy, a new, clean source of power.
Never understood how eels are electric.
I need to get Billy to bed.
Sorry, honey. I lost track of time.
You? No, I'm shocked.
I have to wait for Max to finish, but you go ahead. Take Billy home.
Finally, an adaptation with all the Connors. This is like why his lizard transformation is a big deal, because he's got a family.
Oh.
They never show it.
Dang, all right, I'm
excited.
The
Connors family is hugely important. This is great.
I have to call if I'm not home by 10. Hey, Aunt May, sorry for running late. We just left the lab. I'm going to make sure Gwen gets home safe, and then I'm on my way.
Good boy, Peter.
That's what I would do. I'm like, it's 9:58. Technically, it's not
just
10
when I'm
calling.
I'm doing it 2 minutes before.
He's got 90s next door neighbor hair.
100%. Got that Devon Sawa.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh. Oh, no.
He's going in the eels.
Dang, we're going there right now.
Right away, Electro. Oh. He's going at the eels. They're going to get him.
Oh, my God.
We just saw a man die.
Yeah. Oh,
he's back. It is very Offspring.
Yeah. If they were, yeah, it's like if they were going for a little less punk and a little more of that 90s or 2000s alt. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Little Alien Ant Farm, little Offspring.
You're talking to a guy who had multiple Alien Ant Farm albums. All
right. It just feels right for Spider-Man
to
reference Alien Ant Farm.
That little anti-widow's peak in my hair. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And it does. It makes perfect sense.
Spider-Man, Alien Ant Farm, it's right there.
Yep.
The insect connection is strong.
And every Alien Ant Farm album, or most of them, had an ant pun in the title. So it's perfect. They should
Come
adapt
on.
Them into comics.
Wonder how they're doing. I hope those guys are good.
They're still out there.
Max, how's he doing? Interactions.
Ooh.
It's like a play with people meeting and chemicals, interactions.
There was an accident.
Oh.
We need to quarantine him, get his vitals stabilized. He's getting worse by the minute.
How many accidents do you come in here with?
I mean, it's the place. Just emitting electricity.
Yeah.
Spider-Man 2 pose. Straight out of Sam Raimi's.
Let's get our bridge scene going.
Spider-Man staple.
I'm sure my spider powers can save me this time.
Woo!
Beautiful.
That was fun.
You know, just once I'd like to be early for school.
You're in the wrong line of work,
buddy. Parker luck. Oh, Midtown Manhattan magnate.
There you go. M squared cubed.
Yeah,
math.
Three. M three.
And if you turn M on its side,
oh,
it looks
his
like
little
a
shirt's exposed.
In
oh.
Action.
Oh,
it's not what you think.
It is too doofus. Says so right here.
Flash defensiveness. That's so good.
Then it is what you think.
Oh my god. A job.
Spider picture thing. I told that big mouth Bugle guy to
take photos of someone famous. Yeah. That is revolutionary.
I know you're all eager to get yesterday's
Ouch.
Test back.
Oof,
kid.
C minus. Sweet.
Another A plus.
These kids are all in the magnet program, even though most of them we've seen are failing.
Yep.
Whoa. Whoa. There's a lot of C's.
How's Max?
Alive. It's a miracle, believe me. Whoa. His condition is stabilized, but
maybe he should just see for himself.
Sure.
Max's body is currently generating a constant stream of bioelectricity. That insulation suit will contain it, protect him and everyone.
Cool villain suit.
Dang. Yeah, they just gave it to him.
It's only temporary. We'll begin work on a cure immediately.
Least you can do.
Yeah.
Ominous.
I do like that as a motif. Like, the villain suit is like the thing they put him
the
in just to contain
item.
It. Yeah.
Yeah. And when he breaks free.
Yeah.
If you're going to raise that grade, you need a tutor. And I'm recommending Peter for the job.
Damn.
Peter's got stuff to do.
Quality time with puny Parker? I'd rather fail.
Study with Petey? I don't think so.
Oh, goodness.
Couldn't Flash tutor me instead?
I'm not sure you understand. We want your grade to go up.
My man.
That was so good.
The deadpan, he almost sounds like Alfred Molina, but I don't. Imagine
that'd
it
be
would
incredible
be.
If
it would
they
be cool,
somehow stunt casted Molina.
You know, I had plans before this happened. Go back to college, meet someone.
You have to give yourself time to adjust.
Adjust to what? This?
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Ooh.
Damn. You were adjusting to electrical power with the greatest of ease.
I'm out of here.
No.
See, the chapter's really about how biological systems interact.
Ugh. Interactions.
Maybe if you stop texting Flash for just a minute.
Good idea! I'll call him instead.
Why are you talking to Flash so much? Isn't he with that other
yeah.
girl?
Yeah. What's that set up? Well, that's not
or
suspicious.
Or no, the blonde girl's with the other guy. All right, fine.
Daddy, what's he wearing?
Shh. And what are you staring at?
I was just waiting for your order.
Coffee.
Oh.
I hope he likes it. Extra cream.
Oh, no!
Oh man, I can't even drink a lousy cup of coffee.
Yeah, I'd be mad.
Yeah,
I'd
I don't know. Real mad. Life would be without it.
No more Dunkins.
Nope, not worth it. Not worth living. I'd go villain too.
Look, this tutoring thing is something you need, not me. So when you're ready to learn, let me know.
Yeah.
Respect. Respect go your time, Peter.
Someone's getting paid for Spidey's picture.
Yeah.
Might as well be me. Okay, self-portraits aren't going to be as easy as I thought. What I need is a group shot.
Spider-Man invented the selfie.
Long ago.
Leave me alone.
Oh! Oh no.
Say Spider-Man. Wonderful. You are a very cooperative crook, but I can't get a good mugshot if you're wearing this.
Oh, dang, yeah.
He wouldn't know that it's not safe, but come on, Peter.
Oh, you really shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
Why did you attack me?
Now, now. Attack is such a strong word. All right, Electro.
Hey, got the name. Whoa.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
It should bring in the Amazing Spider-Man talking score music.
Yeah. I'm curious how he's going to take him out in this universe.
Perfect.
Aww, oh, Aunt May.
Hey, Aunt May.
Peter, it's almost 10.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm calling. I've been tutoring. It's slow going, but I'll be home soon.
Oh, boy.
The weatherman predicted rain. You don't have your umbrella.
Just somehow I doubt an umbrella would help. I mean, it's not raining here yet.
Oh, boy.
Okay, bye, Aunt May. Don't wait up.
That phone's got a good voice isolate feature.
Yeah, not hearing that.
And this one would have been great if my arm was 2 feet longer.
You need a wider lens, Pete.
No way the Bugle will take any of these. Not only does lightning butt get away, but I've got nothing to show
Peter.
For-
oh.
I just talked to Eddie. There was an accident at the lab.
Max's life is trashed. And not only don't I recognize him, I attack him. Not sure if I could have helped. At least I could have tried.
Sure.
Lessons.
Look, I feel bad for ditching you last night, so if you still want help, we can meet after school at the ESU lab. It's up to you.
Aww. She's growing a heart.
She's learning how to treat people.
That's her transformation.
Yeah. Interactions.
That's right.
You use a bioelectric filter to siphon off?
No, won't work, I'm afraid. Eels evolved to exist in aquatic environments. Max didn't.
And with the voltage he's currently generating, boom. You don't want him anywhere near water.
Woof.
Max, we need to get you back to the hospital.
Done with hospitals. Just want to go home.
Ooh.
Said Dillion, after last night's little blow-up, it's either a hospital room or a jail cell.
No.
Your call.
My call? My call? None of this has been my call!
Oh, damn. Wardrobe change.
Stop! We just want to help you.
You can't help me, but I know who can.
Ooh.
Something to do with Spider-Man.
Yeah, somehow. Or Curt Connors, maybe. I don't know.
Norman Osborn?
You're smart. You can get this stuff.
Aww.
In nature, everything's connected. As scientists, we explore and expand upon those connections. Maybe as people, we should do the same.
I thought you said this stuff was boring.
Ooh.
You're lucky to have Pete as a tutor, Liz. Guy knows his stuff. Probably a Nobel Prize in his future.
Uh-oh. You don't look so happy about that, Gwen.
Kurt, what are you doing?
Yeah.
An experimental bioformula.
Like it.
Genetically altered lizard DNA.
So we are accelerating villains.
Where's Connors?
Oh, not the beakers and things.
Where's Connors?
Max.
There's science in there.
The science!
I can't take it anymore. You cause this. You cure it.
We're working on that, Max. I promise. It'll just take time.
I don't have time!
Oh, man.
I know you can do it, Doc. All you need is the proper motivation.
The secret identity thing was fun while it lasted.
Yeah. What are you gonna do? Oh, boy. Oh, no, Eddie!
Eddie!
He's valiant.
Come on!
It did work, but
there,
man.
Oh, boy.
Now it's raining.
And
Aunt May was right.
Yeah.
Where's Petey?
She noticed.
Yeah.
Don't hurt him. We'll find a cure. We just need time.
You're lying!
It's not a typhoon.
Guys, I know it's not exactly a cure, but how about some chill pills?
Spider-Man writing is fantastic.
Look, I messed up before, but now I really want to help.
You want to hold my hand?
Ah!
None of you get it! Without a cure, I'm not Max Dillon! I'm what'd you call me?
Lightning Butt?
No!
Lightning Butt.
I'm Electro!
Yeah, you are. Let's go. Ooh!
Ooh. What was that gonna...
Yeah, is that going to alter the, all right, the Electro, secret ingredient?
You want a vent?
Like it activates something and then...
Yeah.
Labs aren't expensive.
Nah. We have infinite funding to repair all this. Ah! You got to get a rubberized suit.
You got to ground yourself.
Oh!
Nice! Yes.
My only chance at a cure, and you let him escape!
I mean, you've been tearing up the room, buddy.
Yeah.
The more science you destroy, the less cure you're gonna get.
I don't know if you can do much in this space anymore.
That's it. The gloves are off.
Yeah.
I like that it's like the comics where they just spank him the first time they encounter.
Yeah.
Like he has to get smart.
That Bugle prize money's as good as mine.
No!
Stand still!
Some kid with an old flip phone.
Oh!
Eesh. Sorry, photo shoot's over. But if those shots come out, I want my cut.
Yep.
Okay, Electro, the gloves are on.
Hey. There we go.
All right.
Now we're using science. Now we're thinking. Give me a rubber punch. Oh, a rubber toss.
So
that's
many
smart.
Rubber moves you could do.
A lot of options, like in a video game.
You can dish it out. But
toss them.
Ah. Whoa.
Can't escape me up there, web slinger.
You and your chelicerates. Nice. Oh. I like the realization of his power.
Okay, maybe climbing a big metal tower wasn't the brightest idea.
There you go, Peter.
In the rain.
Oh, yeah.
Man, where does the time go?
Yeah.
It's always 10 o'clock.
Peter, where are you? You sound strange.
Amazing.
It's a bad connection. Listen, I'm running late again.
Peter, you're taking advantage of our arrangement.
Yeah.
3 for 3.
Sorry, I can't hear you. Static. I'll be home soon. Bye.
I've had this conversation in the past.
Yeah, when I was a kid, I remember that. I mean, he wants to be home.
Yeah. It's funny that the highest concentration of crimes take place between the hours of 9:30 and 10:30 p.m.
That's about when crime starts. Yep. About a crime o'clock.
No, the W!
That's an important letter,
the
Madam Web. That's how Madam Web takes on.
Right.
That's
right. Oh my god, it's all connected. Her guys, web really do be connecting them all.
All of them. The Spider-Verse is connected through Madam Web. I never knew how many important letters were to the canon. Is that just short amount? I hope.
He becomes an eel.
Ooh. Oh! Steamy.
Okay, good. Seems alive. Go home to your aunt.
Oh, yeah. Get out of there.
Petey, what were you thinking last night?
That I should try to help?
And did you?
No. Old Petey's pretty useless, I guess.
Nah.
I wouldn't say that.
Aww.
Ooh.
She catching feels over here?
What's Puny Parker doing here?
Leaving, I hope.
Ouch. Don't be two-faced. Go to him.
Never again. Hope he doesn't forgive you.
Another hapless victim of the wild, undomesticated cheerleader.
It's her loss, Pete.
If the job was to help her learn, at least you taught her how to fold to peer pressure.
Nice.
Not bad, Harry.
You can't control everything. Trick is to never stop trying.
Good lesson.
Boy.
Oh, don't inject the electrified lizard juice into you, Curt.
Yeah, get a new batch, man.
But it looked like he was using it before.
He was.
So therefore, I like that there's an impetus.
Let's go.
Not before I've had my medicine.
Oh, it's fine now. Everything's fine. I like that it's a slow burn lizard, not like an episode where Electro and Lizard become the same day.
Yeah.
Like,
it just makes it feel like a more thriving world, yeah. Where these
I
characters love exist.
The
and skyline, he's always watching.
Spider-Man watching. So many comics end with that imagery. That's fantastic.
Beautiful.
This is the spectacular Spider-Man. It is so far so good. I've been really enjoying it. You want to talk about it?
Let's talk about it.
Ask the pro and go. It's faster, bro. Ladies and gentlemen, I got so excited. They know I got excited when they wanted to partner up with us yet again. And let me tell you why. See, a couple months ago when we were first approached by them for our first sponsored agreement, I wanted to try them out before agreeing to do a sponsorship with them. Reason being is because I get terrible allergies. Roxy Stryer, whenever she shows up here, usually points it out because she happens to catch me on the days when my allergies are acting up. And on top of that too, I have a deviated septum, so I often have a difficult time breathing through my right nostril. I'm a person who needs a nasal allergy spray, needless to say. Didn't mean to rhyme bars. And when I used Astapro, I fell in love. I really believe in this allergy spray. They sent me over that one sample. So the bottle you see in my hand, I don't know what number bottle this is that I personally bought myself. So please, let me tell you a little bit more about them. Astapro is a first of its kind nasal allergy spray, and it is the fastest 24-hour over-the-counter allergy spray. It starts working in 30 minutes while other allergy sprays, they take hours. It's the first and only 24-hour steroid-free allergy spray. It delivers full prescription strength indoor and outdoor allergy relief from nasal congestion, runny and itchy nose, and sneezing. For anyone who experiences allergies or congestion, you know that no matter what you're doing, you just perform better. Once you get that cleared up, Astapro has been the faster pro. It's been the fastest working one for me. So if you want to experience the joy with me, you can get fast-acting nasal allergy symptom relief with Astapro. You can go to astaproallergy.com for a discount so you can use Astapro and go. Astepro. Allergy.com. It's faster, bro. I love it. I say it every time I pick up my bottle. Use as directed for relief of nasal congestion, runny nose, sneezing, and itchy nose due to allergies. Buying via through our link is also a fantastic way to support the channel. Lets you know that we were the ones who directed you there. I really do believe in them. I've been buying them myself. I heavily vouch for them, Reject Nation. Give them a shot. Thank you.
Let's dive into episode 1 and 2 of Spectacular Spider-Man. If you're listening to this on Spotify or iTunes, that we just watched the first 2 episodes back to back. I am actually glad I didn't watch this in 2008 because I was a young man and I was very busy running around and I think I would have like rushed through it. Now I get to appreciate it. I get to know we've had some years of Spider-Man. I also, at this point, this was a year after Spider-Man 3. Correct, because Spider-Man 1 was 2001. Spider-Man 2 was really in a hurry in like 2004, I think 2007. Yeah, I think that's the timeline. So Spider-Man 3 had just come out. So I did not yet know the void of missing Spider-Man.
Sure.
Coming back after the Marvel will they won't they Sony stuff, we had some years without Spidey. So this is cool to experience. I think it's a really great way to teach lessons to kids. There's a lot of really cool, like, you know, very strong morals in it. Mm-hmm. I like the respect you got there for certain characters. I like that we're seeing new characters we don't get to see in other adaptations very often. Like, so far, so good.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, you've got the expert POV, but for me, this was just such a lovely re-entry into, you know, like one of the characters I am more familiar with and I've seen multiple takes on. And so it's lovely to watch something like this that, yes, is like, you know, calling on the pretty, you know, notable pantheon of villains thus far and characters thus far, but is kind of developing itself, at least as of these 2 episodes, in a way that feels like, yeah, these are all just people who inhabit this one big version of New York City. And so, like, yeah, having a brief intro to J. Jonah Jameson, having, you know, Norman Osborn be a presence, but not, yeah, have a rush to get him into Green Goblin mode, or having Curtis Connors, you know, slowly developing and hinting at that. Like, I like things like that where, and even Eddie Brock, like, you know, he's, you know, that seems like something that probably won't come to pass, at least as of my just guesswork here, for a little while. And I like things like that where we can actually just get to know all these people, or at least certain characters, before they turn, and then, you know, develop the tragedy of that. Because I feel like so many times you get, and here, like, it was cool to see Max Dillon and the Electro story take off, and that is an example of something that is more just kind of direct and it happens pretty quick.
And he still felt empathy because he'd met him, but it also isn't the same weight as like a lizard or something.
Yeah, yeah. And I like having that contrast and that balance of things. And yeah, just like the grace with which they're sort of developing all this, but still keeping it fun and still keeping it action-packed. Like, this isn't necessarily the most complicated animation style, but when they're doing the swinging around town and stuff like that,
the energy is really good.
Flourishes, yeah, the energy is great. And the way that they capture that stuff with, you know, background blurring and moving the layers of the city, like, still looks really nice.
I'm curious if, I mean, it seems like Keith David is is Kingpin, but I'm really curious, like, the long game they're playing with characters. I really like that we've got, like, a lot of different elements moving, like his school life, his after work life. Like, Peter Parker's supposed to always be burdened. Like, he's supposed to always have too much to do. So I like this ticking clock thing they added in this episode. I'm sure it's just for this one episode, but I love the Aunt May, like, gotta go. Lacey Chabaza is Gwen Stacy.
I was going to say we should take a look at some of these voices.
I'm really, I assume they're going to do Gwen, not Mary Jane.
That's
because we've seen a lot of Mary Jane, and there's no Mary Jane in the opening credits.
And I was going to say, at the around the time this would have come out, I feel like, you know, the vast majority of noobs, at least, would be mostly associated with Mary Jane. So having a Gwen, you know, as the strong presence, and having that be something that's developing slowly too, and this sort of like thing they're hinting at with I can't remember her name off the dome, but you know, Flash's girlfriend, is that her name?
I think it was Liz Allen.
Liz. Okay, so yeah, like even that, it's like kind of neat and fun. And
these are all comic characters. Liz Allen's in the comics. Gwen is obviously vitally important, and she did start dating Harry before Peter, so that's also from the comics. There was like a weird. And then when Gwen started dating, Harry and Mary Jane started dating. So that was a little thing.
Dang. Okay.
A little swaparoo.
I want my soap opera Spider-Man
That's
over
coming.
Here.
That's coming.
Give me
it's
that.
Coming.
Give me that. How many Marthas are there in comics? Because we got a Martha Connors here, too.
There's enough Marthas. There's just enough. How are you going to stop a big fight unless everybody's got the same mom name?
That's right.
This is important to keep at your back pocket.
Yes.
You know
when
what?
The amalgamated universe finally comes to
you
pass.
You got to be prepared.
And it's like Avengers Justice League 20.
Because Superman's kryptonite's not kryptonite. Martha.
It's Martha.
So when Amalgam comes to pass, the only thing that's going to stop all the Superman blends
is one giant mecha Martha.
And the end of Suicide Squad. Like that giant David Dismalchin's mom. That's the Ulta Martha.
Oh my God.
But I do like that we're getting some villains that we hadn't seen, like the Enforcers. I really enjoy that we're getting some seeds planted. Like Otto was in this as an assistant to Norman, which is. Not generally canon.
Of course, that's who that was. Okay, cool.
It's not 616 canon, but that is Ultimate canon.
Sure.
And Ultimate Spider-Man is one of my favorite runs, and that's also having Eddie Brock introduced as the lab assistant. That's from Ultimate Spider-Man. Like,
okay.
So this is blending some 616 elements, like Jonah, very 616, with the 1610 Ultimate Universe, which lines up timing-wise pretty great. Oh, Phil LaMarr was Randy Robertson.
Yeah. I was going to say, they've assembled a pretty formidable voice cast. I mean, obviously, Dee Bradley Baker is prolific. Dr. Connors.
Yep. Clancy Brown
was in here. Lacey Chabert. John DiMaggio. Prolific voice actor Keith David, the big man. Robert Englund, loved that.
That's cool.
The Adrian Toomes in there.
I enjoyed this.
Beautiful. I love this so much.
Solid cast, solid playfulness. Definitely skews like all ages, which is really good that it's got these messages in there for, you know, the importance of certain things. Like, you can't give up just because someone pushes your hand away doesn't mean you should stop being nice to people. Like, I really like that. I like the softness of Aunt May, and like their relationship's really cool. I also like that it feels friendly neighborhood. Like, this feels like New York.
Well, yeah, it has this quality where, like, when we go to the action stuff, I'm invested in that, but I also want to go back to see some of the school stuff and some of the lab stuff. Like, it's got me interested in everything, and I love little beats like that where he pieces out on Liz and he's like, you know what? You know, it's up to you.
I got self-respect.
I don't need to tutor you. Bye.
And it wasn't mean. He just has self-respect.
And then he comes back and he's like, hey, but he's still like, hey, I'm
still
sorry
Peter Parker.
About that. If you want to be tutored, I'm here.
Right.
You know?
He doesn't do it in a douchey way.
Yeah.
Tobey Maguire, Spider-Man. He does it in a way that is respectful, but also boundary setting.
Absolutely.
I dug this.
Yeah, very much so. And the little, you know, bits with Aunt May and the home life, you know, like that little bit of tension is nice and relatable.
And we did meet Aunt Anna. The woman that Aunt May was talking to is Mary Jane's aunt. Because Mary Jane and Peter Parker meet because they're neighbors. They grew up with each other. So Aunt May's here. Anna is here. Mary Jane's next door. So we have met a way to meet Mary Jane.
I remember that from the one time they took out the trash in the first Spider-Man.
Oh, yes,
movie.
And you learn about the drama for family.
That's right.
Dad's a piece of crap.
He's a crap guy.
Yep, that's comic canon too.
Does he become a villain?
I mean, more of like there's Mary Jane-centric issues where there's like flashbacks and like stuff that like domestic villain.
Okay, he doesn't get powers.
Doesn't get powers. No, all right. Spider-Man's like very everyone gets powers, but at least it's not to the level of absurdity, because sometimes that is absurdity.
Sure.
Mary Jane has powers now, and that's silly. She's such a good, strong character that doesn't need powers, and it's always like, You're kind of like taking away by
I'll
giving her
I'll go get him, Tiger.
Her name's Jackpot, and she has the power of like when she spins this luck thing, she gets a random power. And she teams up with Black Cat a lot because Black Cat has actual luck powers. So she's like, got it's dumb. It's not. It's not.
Sounds good. Dumb.
It's not. She it literally sounds... wears all green and like will mentally spin a wheel and wait for it to be like and doesn't know what her power is going to be. And then she'll be like, I have flight or whatever.
I was going
to
say this power sounds like someone threw a dart at a board with
and
a bunch
her power
of powers.
Stayed throwing a dart at a board.
And then they hit a power and they went, wait a minute. The thing you just did, that's the power.
It's bad. Yeah, the act of getting
the
powers.
The act of trying to choose at random and receiving whatever you got is the power.
And Mary Jane's already like a supermodel turned like club promoter turned entrepreneur
yes.
turned. She literally ran Stark Tech. Like she ran
that,
Stark's
what?
Company for Tony. Yeah, like
what continuity is this?
Main.
Ah.
So she's like a genius businesswoman because she doesn't want to model anymore, doesn't want to be an actress anymore, becomes a businesswoman. Why does she need powers?
As you do.
Why does she need
powers? She's Kim Kardashian.
Yeah, with powers.
With powers.
Guys, comics are crazy. We will be diving into plenty more of this. If you guys enjoyed this, we will be detailing like certain characters. I want to dive into like if you guys want to see certain comic arcs discussed after the characters
ooh,
introduced. Like, for example, this Electro issue. Some of my favorites are in the 420s. there's some stuff. So Amazing Spider-Man. 420. There's some stuff where it's a Steve Skros art. Steve Skros is one of my favorite artists out there. He actually just did some stuff with Berserker because he was the storyboard artist on The Matrix.
Okay.
So him and Keanu are homies.
Okay.
Steve Skros is this incredible detailed artist. He did... like this 3-issue arc of Spider-Man that he gets this rubberized suit. He has to upgrade his powers. X-Man comes in, the other Cable kind of character. Nate Summers, instead of Nathan Summers, whole thing. But I love that extra Electro arc. And then recently he's been in like the Sinister Six again. So if you want to check out Electro stuff. And then when we get to the Lizard episode, I'll give you guys some recommendations. Some Todd McFarlane Electro and Lizard stuff. But yeah, we'll get to there when we get there. But in the meantime, leave a comment below. Let us know what your favorite episode is without spoilers.
Yes.
As we approach going further, please leave a like so we guys know you're enjoying this. And thank you. Thanks for being
thank
part of Reject Nation. Because
yeah.
you were the ones that wanted us to team up again.
Oh, I'm so happy
on the animation.
And
we're
I hope
back.
You like it. I'm so excited for more.
This needs dozens of views because we want to do more of them. Dozens.
Dozens.
If you're a fan of the show, share it. And we want to keep doing these. So much love, Reject Nation. We'll see you soon.
Cameron Lane. Your name got me thinking. There's so many excellent lanes in life. Think of it. Lover's Lane, Candy Cane Lane, Nathan Lane.
Express Lane.
Probably the best lane.
Yeah.
All right. And if you are in the Express Lane, it's all over now, all right?
Left turn lane.
Dedicated left turn lane. Absolutely. Stay in your lane. Just a cultural concept we have, you know, in society. Good one. Lois Lane. One of the best comic book characters of all time.
Yeah.
A lot of prolific actresses have played the role. Lane Bryant, if you need a bra... they got you covered, and that's a necessity for some people, and maybe you need one. I don't know, you know? I don't know what your life is like. I don't know what lane you occupy, but you're in good company no matter what.
Fast pass lane.
The fast pass lane, dude. You are a good time at Disneyland.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Terminal B lane. Yes, if you're at the airport.
Burbank Airport.
Definitely. It's the easiest airport to get through. Be in that lane.
Yeah.
And Cameron. James Cameron. Look
James
there.
Cameron. Yeah.
Look, you even got the other half of your name is Cameron Mitchell is in there.
Cameron Crowe.
Look at all the
directed
Camerons.
Elizabethtown.
You love Elizabethtown. Holy crap. That's a...
We got a zoo.
We bought a zoo.
We bought a zoo. We directed that.
That's a lane of movies is you know,
really good
weird family movies, and you're like, who is this actually for? That's a lane,
yeah.
All right? And they used cameras, which sounds like Cameron,
uh-huh.
And Cameron is also a rapper. Look at that. You are so rich with analogies and related, you know, tangential things.
Cameron Rice, he's the photographer who takes half-naked photos of all the girls
of everyone we know. You are Cameron. Are you Cam Rice photo? Yeah. If you are, take some boudoir shots of us. Yeah. That's a lane we would like to occupy. All right? We appreciate you, Cameron, and we appreciate the fact that you bring so many other rich ideas to mind. A true collaborator in essence, a facilitator in essence. That's what we appreciate about you, as well as your generosity. That's the best lane, all right? The gift card lane. Gift card lane. We love you. Be well, and stay pledged forever, and stay in that lane.
Let's do it.